Hey guys, my name is Morgan and welcome back to today's video. I'm back here at the patch I started quite a while ago. You can see it there behind me. The rain has finally stopped the whole of Friday, the whole of Saturday, the whole of Sunday, like it said. It was absolutely bucketing down and there was easily around 1,000 liters in those tanks that was overflowing and it was absolutely insane. I managed to collect 450 liters. And yeah, I even had the hose pipe coming over and letting some of the water overflow over here just to also help loosen the ground, because in the previous video when I set up this bed, the ground is extremely hard, and the whole reason I let the water kind of run over here just to help it loosen the ground a bit. So yeah, back at it. It's now Monday and you can see it is absolutely amazing. The ground is so nice and soft. I've been doing some tests, like I think this was on Friday and then that was on Saturday, just checking the ground just to see exactly how it's doing. And I can come along over here, put my spade down, give one little push on each side, and it's really so much better. Maybe a little jump will help. There we go. So yeah, it is really good. I'm so excited, very keen to get the space going. And what I also realized, I came, I think it was over here. This is where the old veggie patch never used to reach, because it used to go just along from over there and around to that tree. So this was never used. And now, after the rain, this ground, I think I can come around over here, even as far up here, I can come down and it's even workable up till over here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to extend all of these beds just until it reaches this path over here, because this is the dog's kind of like walking path. They always walk along here, so I don't want to have my beds going over that, because I'll stay naturally going to walk over my beds. So yeah, I'm going to extend them, so even with this bed over here, it's gonna come and end probably, so here's the path I'm standing on, the path, it'll probably end around there. So yeah, going to maximize the growing space. It's going to be absolutely insane. So yeah, first going to make a border around everywhere, just to see exactly where I need to dig. It just makes things a little bit easier as well, instead of kind of eyeing it as I'm going. It's nice to make some lines, get the whole thing set out, nice plan going. And yeah, so today is going to be another video of just setting up this veggie patch and getting some nice big beds going. So that is the borders done. You can see I went a little bit around over here because I don't want to go too close to the tree's roots, because the trees can absorb a lot of moisture and the plants growing down, I don't really want, because you see there's some big roots coming off of this one, so I don't want them to interfere too much. So I just went a little bit around there and I came up and I tried to make them as straight as possible. I think these two are straight and those two are straight. Yeah, because I'm just trying to, I don't want to come too close to the path, and yeah, just for a little bit of symmetry. Yeah, I think all of them are actually a little bit of a different length, but it's fine. I'll make them clean line. I'll make them nice and smooth when I go through to make it look like this one here. So yeah, now it's time to come again with the spade and just go through all of the beds and loosen up the ground. Although the ground is nice and soft now, I know that when it starts to become a little bit more sunny and warm up, although it is winter, but like, you know, like gets a little bit warmer than what it is now, in the midday kind of, it's going to get hard again. It happens every single time, so I won't be surprised if it does it again. So yeah, this is what the average size of the bed is going to be. Then there's a path, there's a path, there's another one, two, and three beds. So yeah, definitely very excited. I'm absolutely loving this. Where's my spade? There's my spade. So time to get back with the spade and get these beds nice and loose, and to remove all of the grass and any of the weeds that's on top as well. Well, something very interesting happened. Can anyone please explain what just happened? So I was busy working here and I was going, and then I took a step back and I've sunk like straight into the ground, and it looks like there's a tunnel. Is it a mole? It's absolutely massive. There's a tie. I don't know if there's something down there. I just touched something. I think it was a root. Check that. It is absolutely massive. What? So yeah, if anyone maybe knows, because I know them down at the bottom there was a tree that we cut down and we like poisoned, like tried to kill it or whatever. And then all of the roots that were coming out, they rotted away, and then it made these little indents in the ground, and if you walk over it, it falls in. But there's no trees around here that's like rotted away or that we've had to remove. Yes, there was a molehill here this morning, but that's huge. That's absolutely massive. I don't know if that's a mole, or I have absolutely no idea. We don't have raccoons don't usually burrow, but we don't have like strange animals and all kinds of wildlife that would do something like this. Like, we don't need to protect our crops and like our dogs from all kinds of crazy creatures. So this is kind of strange. I'm really not too sure what this is about. So yeah, if you guys have any idea, let me know in the comments, what could this possibly be? Right, so this part is finally done, this one bed over here. I'm gonna take a bit of a break and I'm gonna carry on later. This is what I've done so far, looking absolutely amazing. All I've done was extended it from, I think it was about there, just to the end here, and I did put some fresh compost on top. So yeah, it is looking absolutely amazing. This is so much growing space. I'm so happy. I'm thrilled. I'm so excited. I can't wait to have some cool plants growing in here. But yeah, there's still a lot of work to do. So time for a little break, and then I'm gonna carry on a bit later. The sun is down, the bed is complete, and yeah, this is what it looks like. So, not too bad for today. Very pleased with what has happened. So yeah, tomorrow is going to be the same process. So I'll probably see you guys maybe when I've got one more bed done. It's going to be the same process, the same digging and taking out all the grass and weeds. So I'll see you guys in a bit. It has been around 3 days of solid work here at the side of the house, doing all of this patchwork, getting some beds ready and digging the ground and whatever. And I'm finally done, so this is what it looks like. I think it looks absolutely insane. I am so excited. I went around and I used a old broomstick just to make some holes, just so I don't have to bend down so much because there's so many holes that I need to make here. And I went through one of the beds and I checked and I have space for over 700 seedlings. All of the space, all three of these beds can hold over 700 seedlings. So I'm probably going to be doing one bed at a time because I don't really have that kind of money on me right now to go and get 700 seedlings. But yeah, stay tuned, there's going to be some very cool content coming with this side of the garden and all kinds of seedlings on the way. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you really enjoy. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button, and until next time, have a wonderful day and stay active in the garden.
Amen.
When you speak, angels sing from above. And every day what seems.
Hey, you must have fetched this from the compost now as well. Literally.